Hi, I'm Nicholas DiMario of SterlingKisses.com, and today we're going to take a look at the Freeform Pico, a 3D printer made by Asiga. Let's check it out.
This is the Freeform Pico 33. Because of the high quality parts it can make, this printer was designed for the jewelry, dental, and medical industries. The printer itself doesn't take up much space. It's about the size of a coffee maker, but taller. The Pico uses SLA technology, so as opposed to a plastic extrusion printer like a MakerBot for example, this machine prints from a vat of liquid resin. One of my favorite things about this printer is the variety of materials you can use with it. Asiga offers their own range of materials from plastic to castable, but you can also use third-party materials as well. There's not much to it as far as components and maintenance goes. There's the replaceable resin tray, and a safety tray below that, which sits inside the machine to protect the projector. The only other removable component is the build platform, which you see lowering here for calibration. Another component that requires calibration is this slide plate. It prepares each successive layer of a print. It takes about 5 minutes to calibrate the Pico, and it's not something I have to do too often. The Pico comes with a piece of software called Composer, which lets you create supports for your parts and arrange them for printing. Here we see a ring that I've made which is already set up with supports. I can easily reposition it and create duplicates to fill the build platform. I can usually fit about 6 rings or pendants on the build platform at once. The software features a way to auto-arrange parts and create supports. Sometimes it does a good job, or at least it gets you a good start, but I like to do it by hand. Before printing, the Composer software lets you select what material you're printing in and the thickness of each layer. I usually print at 15 microns. Now this is where the fun starts. Composer lets you edit the default settings for each material. You can change the exposure time, the slider speed, add a wait time between layers. There's so many options to play with. This is also where you would enter custom settings for third-party materials. Once all that's done and you send your Composer file to the Pico, it will show you a cross-section view of how it's going to be printed, which I think is pretty neat. What you see here is layer after layer of what the projector is exposing to cure the resin. Now we start our grow and let the machine do its work. These rings took a little over 7 hours to print. These rings were printed using Asiga's Super Wax material. They have to be post-cleaned in isopropyl alcohol, then cured with UV light. I usually go one extra step further and heat cure them in a kiln. Some of these castable resins need special treatment for a clean burnout. Once the prints are fully cured, the supports are cut free and the pieces are sprued to a wax tree. I add vents to the pieces so I can vacuum out any ash residue that might remain after burnout. It's an extra step, but it just ensures a clean casting. I also use Plasticast Investment and use boric acid to strengthen that mix even further. There's all sorts of little tips and tricks to help improve the burnout and casting of these resin parts. I could devote an entire video to it. I'm hoping to try some new materials soon that claim to burn out just like wax. The sprue tree is placed in a flask, investment is poured, and the burnout begins. Eight hours later, I'm ready to cast.
That was awesome.
It was awesome.
Yay, Nick's smiling, yes. All right.
Here are the pieces straight out of the flask. And here they are with a tumbled finish.
So there it is, the Asiga Pico. It's been a great little printer, and it's been a great addition to my shop. I hope you've enjoyed this little behind-the-scenes tour of my workflow and how I use the printer, and if you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. Once again, I'm Nicholas DiMario of SterlingKisses.com. Thank you for watching.